you know, something drastic. Yes. Now the sciences have developed what they call delivery systems, and again, doctor understands this better than I do. But they can make particles that are so minute that it can get into your skin and hit the targeted area that you're supposed to be treating. That's what they call a delivery system.
Okay, so doc, tell us more about the delivery system.
Okay, because you know the skin is supposed to be a barrier, and water cannot penetrate. You know, noxious chemicals cannot penetrate. Now there are delivery systems that are like liposomes. They make medications easier to penetrate. I think that's what he's talking about.
Okay, so people are saying that when you reach 18, you start using sunblock and things like that. What is the youngest age that you can start off with?
Oh, you can start as a baby. You should protect.
Really?
Yeah, you should protect yourself from the sun. Babies are supposed to be given sunblock.
Wait. Well, a baby likes to bite on anything. What if they happen to like
lick
bite on their arm, and you know?
Yeah, if they lick it.
You know,
kids like to chew on anything.
Because there are sunblocks for kids that are formulated for kids.
Okay, that's right.
And then they can start using that on their face no matter how old they are.
Yeah, and there are physical sunblocks that are just like titanium dioxide. There are minerals, zinc oxide.
Okay, so what are the other things there?
What are the colored ones, Bob?
Yeah, the orange and the purple and the green.
These these are antioxidants. This is a higher level. Flavocy serum is a favorite of a lot of people that I know of.
Because?
It contains, aside from L-ascorbic vitamin C, it also contains ginkgo biloba.
So what is that?
Are they tablets?
In liquid form? Or?
No, it's a serum.
It's a serum that you just, how do you apply it?
You apply it on your face.
On your face. Yeah. See? Buti na lang, he told me, inumin ko na sana.
I know, right? Sayang.
That's why it's important to see a dermatologist.
So yeah, before buying any product, it's always important that you see your derm because they may be able to tell you things about your skin that you are not necessarily aware of.
That's right.
Okay, so all these products
we're missing one more. Okay,
this one?
Yeah. And
this is for hyperpigmentation. It blocks melanogenesis.
Okay, what's that, doc? What's up, doc?
It's production of pigment by the melanin, by the pigment cells.
Okay, which causes those little like
the pigmentation. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm sure many people who are watching us want to know how much these products cost. I mean, like maybe let's
price
say they
range.
only have a certain amount.
Yeah, actually they range from, I would say, between 2,000 to maybe 3,000. So not very expensive, yes.
Okay.
And where do they find it?
Our products are sold mostly through dermatologists. Prime Skincare Asia is one of our clinics that support us and sell some of our products.
And usually one would last like maybe for 2 months?
Yes, 2 to 3 months.
So if you divide that, that's like 1,000 a month, or even less than that. Okay, let's say I only had 2,000. What product would you recommend that I buy? Let's say I could only buy one. Which one?
See, that's where I would say the doctor should recommend.
There you
so
go.
So we will, before you answer.
If you're very concerned with your dark circles, then that's the one.
So
that
whatever,
you get.
Whatever you are more concerned about, or
of
whatever
course.
You think you need.
Yep.
Let's say we don't feel we need anything.
But maybe you still have sunblock. To, you know, sunblock because it prevents aging.
Okay, I'd go for the tinted sunblock. Which one would you go for?
After you tell me about it, then I will decide.
Okay, so we'll decide and we'll let you know when you come back. So don't you go away.
Nagbabalik po ang She Said, and kasama pa rin po natin si Bobby at si Dr. Agnes. And Agnes, you wanted to, I'd like to know more about the Philippine Dermatological Society.
Okay, it has a program, it's called the Skin Safety Campaign, because you know now, There are a lot of skin doctors who are not really trained. You know, in the Philippine Dermatological Society, it takes like you have to have 3 years of training mm-hmm. in an accredited institution, and then you have to take an exam. That's only when you can be called a real dermatologist.
Okay, how do you know if you're a real dermatologist or not?
They to have that license displayed in their.
We go inside a salon, and then what do we look for?
Not salon, a dermatology clinic.
Yeah, that's right. No, exactly. That's why people go inside a salon, and then they get facials and everything, and they say, you know, they say
you
it's safe.
That's where they used to get their facials.
People don't know that.
Okay, a real dermatologist has to be board certified, okay?
Okay, so they have to have that plaque. And it has to be a clinic and not in a salon.
Well, actually, now there are salons who employ dermatologists.
Yes.
Yeah, so do we look for their license?
You can ask, do you have a board certified dermatologist? You can ask that.
Okay. And then when they show us, okay, this is Dr. blah, blah, blah. Can we see your certificate?
I just want to share a story.
Well, you can be honest.
It really should be displayed because many people just want the business. And they say this is doctor, like, you know.
A friend of ours who had like guested on the show, his girlfriend had her behind like augmented, and there was like something that happened. It just kept bleeding, and so she had to go in for surgery. It was bleeding again, so she had to go in for surgery again, mm-hmm. and then she almost even died because it like started to poison, you know, her whole body. And what they did was this. Whoever did it just paid her like ₱1,000,000. But how can it be worth your health and your life? And
₱1,000,000 so that she wouldn't sue?
So she wouldn't sue, or so she would not say anything because, you know, they're going to lose business. So this is why it's really important to make sure that you go to a real certified
doctor.
Because you don't want to risk your own life, mm-hmm. you know?
Of course. Yeah. People are budgeted and they go to whomever will say, can do this for them.
Or the case of the beauty queen, remember? The beauty queen who had a liposuction not too long ago in some clinic, and then she died. Remember that?
A couple of years ago.
It was done somewhere in Manila. So this is why we have to remind you guys, in your effort to look good, remember safety first. Mm-hmm. Make sure you go to a doctor that has all the proper papers to prove that they really studied and they're authorized to do, especially operations.
Yeah. So in this campaign, what exactly are you doing?
Well, we have this guesting in shows and inform the public.
Mm-hmm. Just awareness.
Yeah, awareness campaign.
Okay, and then for people like us and for our
you know,
guests
you can look at the, you know, the prescription pad of the doctor. If it says PDS, and then they can be DPDS is a diplomate or fellow.
Mm-hmm.
Then you're sure.
Then that's right.
They're certified. Yeah.
But what if somebody just prints that?
You can't do that. You can't just do that.
Really, you can go to a printing company and have it printed.
But you can verify it with a PDS. I'm sure you can call and find out.
Is there a number that we can call? A website? Hotline?
PDS.org.
Okay. PDS.org. Okay.
Yeah, so make sure before you make an appointment with whoever you think mm-hmm. you want to trust. So make sure you check them out make sure they're okay.
Or usually when you go to a clinic, it would be because of word of mouth, because somebody referred you to mm-hmm. them. And not like, you know, you can just walk in there.
Or sometimes it's because there's like some derm clinic in the corner from where you live and it has advertise really cheap rates.
Yeah,
these are the ones you should be worried about.
It promises to do all these things to you, and then you just go there.
Yeah, so make sure you know what you're getting into. Mm-hmm. So remind them again, when's it going to be?
Oh, we have a postgraduate courses for dermatologists.
Now, we have some other products here in front of us. Would you like to tell us about it, Bobby?
Bobby, I was asking you what's
love all these
body
products.
Refinish.
Yeah, well, I wanted to segue your comment about dermatologists, because like ourselves, we're just in business to make money, mm-hmm. And a lot of times people ask, where can we get your products, can we buy directly from you? And
yes.
We always say, you know, while we want to make money off these people, we want to refer them to dermatologists who will prescribe.
Yes,
because a lot of times these, you know, people, we don't know what your condition is. For example, you might be allergic to certain things.
Yes.
You might be pregnant. You mm-hmm. might be undergoing chemotherapy. We don't know.
So your products are not hypoallergenic?
Most of them are not, but like I said, you have different types of individuals, yes. And who knows what they're allergic to.
Or their medical history.
That's why, right. We don't sell directly to the public. We always, mm-hmm. go through the skincare.
So usually the doctors will be the ones to say if they're safe or not.
And you might not even need it. You know, you're, mm-hmm. throwing money and you don't need it.
Okay, so tell us about
these. These seem pretty safe. An exfoliating cleanser. Is it just for the face or the body?
Skin refinish. 20%?
Usually, when we talked about you know, taking care of your skin, you start with a cleanser, mm-hmm. And this is the cleanser. It's
face or whole body? Because it looks big enough for the whole body.
It's probably for the. It's a face that you always want to show, so I would say it's, do it, right. for your face.
Okay, and
exfoliating cleanser.
It exfoliates because you know you have dead skin that you have to.
And remove impurities to restore balance, clarity, and tone.
Okay, and what's a body refinish? Well, you have to finish your body again.
Yeah, well, this one is the moisturizer. Again, this is for the face.
Okay. What's it smell like?
Nothing.
Okay. What's good about this is, you know, we all always talk about glycolics, which is based on sugar cane. This is from bitter almonds and apple.
Bitter almonds and apple. Okay.
And it's really designed for ethnic skin. Because you know when they design...
ethnic skin?
Yes. Darker... You know, not maybe
Asian
not for
skin.
You, but yeah.
Okay. So,
no, we have a lot of ethnic skin here in this country.
Sure, and mm-hmm. and that's why it's designed for people in the Philippines.
Okay, first you cleanse and then you moisturize.
Moisturize. Yeah.
Tone. Tone's the next step.
Yeah. Well, you could apply a toner, but in this case, I think you can go directly to that.
So CTM, cleanse, tone, and moisturize.
Okay, how do you use the body refinish? That's after.
The body is for the rest of your body. Because it's bigger, so it's about the same price.
Like lotion.
Yeah, because this is actually the it's called Skin Refinish, and it's the actual product that will take care of the uneven pigmentation, acne scarring.
So you do the skin refinish after the body refinish. Is that how it goes?
This one goes for the rest of the body. This one is for the face.
Oh, look at this! I twisted it, and then it pops up.
Yeah, that way when you travel, you don't have to risk it like. Spilling on other stuff and making sure you store it correctly.
Right.
Okay.
So, and when I asked, you know, the old name was Mama Lotion, and people made fun of it, but it's
there
kind
already
of
a, is a Mama brand here.
Yeah.
Mama's
Mama
Love.
Lotion.
This is from the
care.
U.S. though.
Okay.
So it's patented there, and they changed it to M2. That's like the new next generation.
And what does it stand for?
Mandelic Malic.
Okay.
So and this is like the Mama Lotion.
Yeah. The old Mama Lotion.
The old one. How much is one of these?
I would say that's probably in the 3-5 range.
But just as well you change it, Mama Lotion seems like it's only for mothers. So, you know.
Yeah, that's what people thought. Yeah, they made fun of it. But, you know, it's like the mother of all things, you know, when you say mother.
Okay. So what else do we have?
Basically, that's it. This is the body refinish. Mm-hmm. And that's the skin refinish. Because you don't want to apply something. It's a lower concentrate. It's like 12%.
Softens tough, dry skin, firms and smoothens.
Do you have a website for people that just want to look and just browse through the products and everything to see which one they think is best for them?
I would say go to www.JEUNESSEManila.com. JEUNESSE is JEUNESSE Manila.
So do you have anything for marks, to remove marks?
That actually addresses all those. It's acne scarring.
Okay, we'd like to thank you for coming on the show today, Dr. Agnes and Mr. Bobby.
I like these all. Thank you very much for the products.
So don't forget, guys, cleanse, tone, moisturize. We'll be right back. Oh,
hold on. Oh, yes. We have some facial soap for you. Not that you need it, but just to maintain your nice looks, and some hot chocolate from Classic Herbs Barbary.
Exchange gift.
Thank you very much.
Thank
and
you.
I can take this. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We'll be right back. Don't go away.
I can share.
Holding there.
I know this is the dark circles under the eyes. This is what I need.
Well, let's share.
Okay, let's share.
You keep it for the first month, and by then there's nothing left.
And then nothing left under my eyes. And then
okay,
let you
there you go.
Right?
Yeah. So don't forget, folks. Cleanse,
tone, and
moisturize. I think moisturize is really important.
Yes. And especially for you know, like we age, it's always nice to have supple skin.
You know, the people that I spoke to that have really nice skin, it turns out they used to moisturize at even an early age. So when you moisturize, they say that it even avoids you getting wrinkles in the future.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
See, I never knew that.
See, because we found out too late in life.
Yeah, we should have started
when
earlier.
We were younger, I used to tell my mom, can I use that? She's like, you're too young. See?
Yeah, and then mean nothing.
Mom, but it's your fault.
My children like to use it, and now I'll say, okay, yes, you can use it.
Give them everything. But that's expensive, huh, to give them.
Of course, yeah. It's expensive. They have like, at least the sunblock. I think that's the safest.
Okay. Make sure it has UVA and?
UVB.
There you go.
Yes.
So we'd like to thank a few of our friends.
Yes, we'd like to thank United Power Systems Philippines Incorporated. Thank you very much to Concho and Associates for our set. Thank you also to Bujilayug. Thank you to Mabolo for our fresh flowers. Thank you to Shemian Manila, and thank you to Classic Herbs Corporation. Nagpapasalamat rin po kami sa halamanan ni Kalia for our fresh plants
for
behind
halaman.
Us. Yes, maraming salamat rin po sa 360 Degrees Fitness Club.
I'd like to thank Metro, Beverly Hills 6750, Tony and Guy. From Tony and Guy, who do you have to thank? I have to thank Christy for my fringes that she just got
and
today.
And Andy. Thank you, Andy.
Thank you, Andy, and thank you, TJ and Wendell, for going with Remy to buy
you,
our food.
And thank you to Cherry and Chot also.
Thank you to Organique Asahi Berry. Thanks, Kathy.
Thank you, Kathy.
I feel so much better drinking it. How do you feel?
Yeah, I love it.
I know, right? And we'd like to thank SM. We've got it all.
Yes, thank you to SM Department Stores.
And thank you to Fairy Marshall, my accessories.
So we'll see you all
next week right here on She Said.
Yes, more beautiful. Bye.